Hi, it's Dr. Ko here from Reset Ketamine and wanted to share with you the different bioavailabilities of ketamine use. So here at Reset Ketamine, we use IV ketamine. And the great thing about IV ketamine is that it is 100% bioavailable. Now, other times you can use intramuscular ketamine, but the bioavailability is a bit lower. It's about 93%. Another form of ketamine is intranasal. And some studies are showing that that is about 45% bioavailable. Now, other times we prescribe ketamine for home use, and either that's sublingual or oral ketamine. And studies have shown that sublingual ketamine is about 19 to 50% bioavailable. Lastly, you have oral ketamine, which is about 17 to 27% bioavailable. It'll really depend upon how the ketamine is absorbed and how it's used. So that's one of the downsides of using other forms of ketamine, is that you don't quite know how much ketamine someone is going to receive because of that variability. The nice thing about IV ketamine is that it is 100% available, so you can titrate to the exact milligram of what the patient needs and what will be most effective for them. Also, if you're using IV ketamine, because it is 100% bioavailable, you don't need to use as much. And although ketamine is a great drug and it's a safe drug, it can cause potentially liver problems, kidney problems, gallbladder problems. So ideally, you want to use the minimal effective dose. So let me know if you have any questions about this regarding bioavailability of ketamine, and let me know what you think. I will catch you next time.